Hey guys, how's it going? We're having a wonderful week, like always, a wonderful weekend. It is Sunday, which means I'm continuing with my Madonna music video journey. And we made it to her MDNA era from 2012. And in today's video, I'll be watching three music videos: Gimme All Your Lovin' with Nicki Minaj and MIA, and Girl Gone Wild and Turn Up the Radio. I do recall seeing the music video for Gimme All Your Lovin' all the way back in 2012, 8 years ago. I barely remember what happens in it. I remember a couple scenes, but this will be a great refresher. And I also recall watching the music video for Girl Gone Wild in 2012, but once again, I don't really know what happens in that video. I vaguely remember it. And 100%, I haven't seen the music video for Turn Up the Radio, so this will be my very first time watching that music video. But anyway, enough talking, let's jump into the first music video for Gimme All Your Lovin'. Oh, I remember this. Oh my God. Oh yeah, this was the year she did the Super Bowl. I forgot about that. I love her walk there. That's cool. I just love her, I love her walk in this music video. I mean, who wouldn't take a bullet for Madonna? Ooh. Oh God, it's like a Super Bowl orgy. Oh wow. That poor baby. Wow, this was so much fun to watch. And I forgot that 2012 was the year that Madonna did the Super Bowl, which I will be doing a video for in the new year. I really did love the football theme of the video. I thought it was cute and I liked the concept. I also loved all her looks in the video, in particular the one where she was channeling her inner Marilyn Monroe. It was taking me back to 80s Madonna, Material Girl and Vogue. It does say here that the video shows Nicki Minaj and MIA in cheerleader outfits cheering on Madonna, who wears a black outfit for most of the video. It then leads into a scene where Madonna, Minaj, and MIA are all dressed as Marilyn Monroe. And it also says that the video was shot in just 2 days in New York. And apparently, the set was surrounded by police patrol and security guards, and mobile phones were not allowed. Some of the sequences in the video was Madonna's idea, like one scene featuring her dancing in front of a wall, which Megan Fox, the director of the music video, felt would not go with the main narrative. However, Madonna insisted on keeping it, and by the second day of filming, she wrapped up early and left. Now, I'm well aware that a lot of people don't like Madonna's MDNA album. A lot of her longtime fans don't like her MDNA album, which is understandable. I see why a lot of people don't gravitate towards it. A lot of people say it's her worst album, but you know what? I've said this many times already, I'm gonna say it again. I'm an EDM guy, so I love my EDM music, so that's probably why I gravitate towards the album so much. I think it's a great album. I think there are a lot of great, not just catchy songs, but I feel like the production on that album is great. It really does fit into the times of 2012 and the early 2010s. Has that electronic sound to it. Do I think it's one of her best albums of all time? No. Do I think it's one of her most creative and ambitious albums of all time? Hell no. But it's fun to listen to. That's why I ranked it so high on my Madonna album ranking list, because I just like going back to it. I will say though, Gimme All Your Lovin' isn't one of my favorite tracks from the album. I do go back to it for nostalgic purposes, but it's not really one of the go-to tracks on the album in my opinion. Do I think the music video for Gimme All Your Lovin' is one of Madonna's best music videos ever? Hell no! But it's fun, and I enjoyed looking at it. And we really haven't seen something like this from a Madonna music video, so I enjoyed it. I will say though, one of the most humorous parts of the video was the very end where she was holding the fake baby, and then she just tossed it to the side off camera, as though it was a football. I imagine this is the closest we'll ever get to a football orgy in a music video. So now we're gonna move on to the next music video for Girl Gone Wild. Oh, I'm getting Erotica vibes. I have the sudden urge to take my clothes off. So much skin. I love it. Something interesting is happening in my pants right now. Yes, this is what I wanted from her Hard Candy era. These concepts and the artistry and the ambition. And this was taking me back to her Erotica era, and I really enjoyed it. She was also bringing back the smoking a cigarette, which was taking me back to her Bad Girl music video. I mean, Madonna was definitely a bad girl in this video. She was a girl gone wild. All the skin and just all the expressions on all their faces, the guys' faces, it was like they were moaning. It just very sensual, and I mean, this was an orgy. I really liked the parts with the black background, the black wall, and there's holes through the wall as though a bullet went through, and there's so many of them. It's almost like a sky, a dark evening sky filled with stars, and the light is kind of shooting out of each of the holes. I feel like this is the most excited I've been for a Madonna music video since her Hug Up music video in 2005. Actually no, maybe Sorry. I'll say Sorry instead. This is the most excited I've been for a music video since Sorry. To me, the two best sides of Madonna is her dad's side, where she gets up on the dance floor, she pulls some moves out, and then her sex side, her controversy side, her sexuality, her erotica side. So to me, those are the two best parts of Madonna that I always look forward to seeing. And Girl Gone Wild is definitely one of my favorite tracks from her MDNA album. It says here that the black and white video opens with Madonna with a retro glam look, followed by scenes of her against a stark white background, erotic scenes with shirtless nude male models, and a dance sequence with heeled male dancers. Censored and uncensored versions of the video exist. I'm curious to know which version I watched. The last time I watched an uncensored Madonna music video that dealt with sex was her Erotica music video, and you won't be able to find that reaction on my channel anymore because it was deleted. Oops. But anyway, let's move on to the final music video of her MDNA era, which is Turn Up the Radio. Get out of my face. God. I love the fashion in this video. Oh my gosh, she's running out of space in that car. Oh wow.
La festa è finita adesso. Allacciati la cintura, stronzetta.
Well guys, it's 3 for 3. I really enjoyed the music videos from this MDNA era. I didn't think I would enjoy them as much as I did. Once again, I really enjoyed the concept in this video, and this is something she really hasn't done before in one of her other music videos, where she was driving around in this beautiful vehicle. Well, she technically wasn't driving, she was in the back seat, and she had a chauffeur, and she was pulling people into her car, and she was just having a great time. I like the contrast between the beginning of the video, where she was really annoyed with the paparazzi, she just wanted to escape, she wanted to turn up the radio, and then the second she did that, she started having a great time pulling people into her car. Also, my favorite part of the music video was when she was in the back seat having a good time and the people were running after her, which was a really cool part of the video. I really need to know where this music video was filmed because the location was absolutely gorgeous. It says here that after a successful escape from the paparazzi, Madonna rides through Florence, Italy, picking up the best looking men on the roadside. Oh, so she was picking up the best looking men. I'm insane, let's be real. And also, censored and uncensored versions of the video exist. What could she have possibly done in the video to make it uncensored? I will say though, her chest was quite distracting in the video. If you see the video, you'll know why. They're quite voluptuous. I was getting total summer vibes from this video, which I love because we are in the dead of winter right now. It's December. And I'm very much looking forward to warmer temperatures in the spring and the summer. Ugh. I also like how she put more thought into these music videos than her Hard Candy music videos. I did not like the music videos from her Hard Candy era at all, with the exception of 4 Minutes. And these were a lot better. What I also liked about these music videos, in particular the third one for Turn Up the Radio, there was an actual storyline happening, which that was taking me back to old school Madonna, because a lot of her earlier music videos had a storyline, and I missed that. I liked the filter used on the video, so it looked vintage, and Madonna herself reminded me of a starlet from the 70s. And I will say that out of the 3 music videos I watched from her MDNA era, Turn Up the Radio was probably my favorite because I liked the storyline. I liked the fashion. Madonna seemed really happy. She was having a good time with everyone in her car. The people were chasing after her. So in my opinion, this is the best video out of the 3. If I could choose another song from her MDNA album to have a music video, I would probably choose, I don't know, I really liked Gangbang, and I also enjoyed Love Spent and Masterpiece. Probably Masterpiece, Love Spent, or Gangbang. And don't even get me started on B-Day song. Ugh. But anyway, what did you guys think of her MDNA music videos? Maybe you didn't like them as much as me, which is totally fine. So in my next Madonna video, we'll be moving on to her Rebel Heart era, and I will be watching 3 music videos in that video: Living for Love, Ghost Town, and Bitch, I'm Madonna. So look out for that video in the new year, and have a happy new year, have a happy holiday season, and I will see you on the flip side. I will see you next year in 2021. Take care.